There was a time when nerds and geeks were laughed at and called names, but times have changed. Geeks are cool now, but they still seem to have a tough time finding romance.
Does this mean you like me?
Yes.
No.
I don't know.
Fear not, for it has been done before. Here are 10 movie moments when the geek got the girl, and how they actually did it. But before we get your love life sorted out, don't forget to hit subscribe to find more videos like this one. Deadpool. Sure, he masturbates with little furry unicorns, but even the merc with the mouth can find a way to get a hot girlfriend. How does he do it? With his sense of humor.
You should have seen your face.
I don't know what to do.
Wade Wilson takes absolutely nothing seriously, and it's his constant joking around that first attracts Vanessa to him.
Did I leave the stove on?
You might argue that his rugged good looks didn't hurt, but even when he loses those and looks like an avocado, Vanessa still loves him. Neuroscientists at Stanford University conducted a study that monitored brain patterns in males and females while they were watching something that made them laugh. They concluded that girls' brains have a higher reaction to humor than guys do, so they get more of a positive experience out of laughing. That's why even a comic book nerd like Ryan Reynolds was able to marry girls like Scarlett Johansson and Blake Lively. Beauty and the Beast. This is the prime example of how you don't need good looks to win over a girl. The Beast looks, well, like a beast, and he must win the heart of another to break the spell before his 21st birthday, or he will remain a beast for the rest of his life. Enter Belle, an adventurous bookworm with beauty beyond compare, every geek's fantasy. The Beast starts out with quite the temper, but when he learns to control it and actually lets his guard down, Belle begins to see the real him. The Beast begins to fall in love, and she with him, but only after he overcomes his insecurities and lets the real him shine through. His shared love for literature and his massive library didn't hurt either. In the end, he simply had to be himself, and everything else fell into place. The Amazing Spider-Man. Before he was amazing, Peter Parker was an average, shy, geeky guy who knew his way around his science textbook. In the film, Peter comes across Flash Thompson bullying another kid in the schoolyard. All of the other kids chant along and encourage the behavior, but Peter pushes through the students and confronts Flash head-on. He then proceeds to get his butt kicked, but his heroics don't go unnoticed. Gwen Stacy, his crush, breaks up the fight and admires his courage in the face of adversity. The two eventually develop a friendship and start dating.
What's your name?
You don't know my name.
He didn't need a tight red suit and superpowers. He didn't even need to win the fight.
Stand up, Parker!
All he had to do was stand up for what was right, and he got the girl of his dreams. Well, one of the girls of his dreams. Scott Pilgrim versus the World. Scott is a nerdy gamer with his sights set on the new girl in town, Ramona Flowers. Unlike most guys, Scott actually works up the courage to talk to her at a party. But similar to most guys, he's so nervous that he can't seem to make any sense. Funny enough, researchers at Queen's College discovered that women find guys more attractive when they know that the guy is nervous but still makes an effort to talk to them. Scott gets embarrassed and leaves, but he's a tenacious fellow. He creates a scenario where he would see her again, and this time works up the courage to ask her out. She says yes, the two start dating, and they live happily ever after. Well, first he has to defeat her 7 evil exes. But that's beside the point. The point is, this geeky kid actually worked up the courage to talk to a girl, and even after making a fool of himself, asked her out on a date. Guardians of the Galaxy. Peter Quill fancies himself quite the ladies' man, but it's obvious to the viewers, and most everyone around him, that he's kind of a dork. But that's okay, girls love dorks. But he does have a certain quality that makes him stand out from his nerdy Terran brethren, his confidence. While some might say he's too confident, to the point of being cocky, it still works for him because his goofiness balances it out. It certainly works for Gamora. Dr. Craig Malkin found that both men and women prefer a confident date because they seem more trustworthy, more fun, and more interested in them.
Should've learned.
I don't learn.
Chris Pratt in the real world is just as dorky and just as confident as his Marvel counterpart, which would explain why he was able to land the equally funny and attractive Anna Faris. Not only was he able to use his confidence and sense of humor to find a girl,
you've seen what it does to people,
but he found a girl who has similar qualities and interests, and their marriage has been going strong since 2009. Kick-ass. As it turns out, a tight suit and a mask are actually pretty sexy to girls. Now, we aren't suggesting that you dress in spandex and a cape, but taking care of your appearance never goes unnoticed. Dave was just a normal comic book nerd, but gets inspired by the comic books he reads and decides to become a hero and fight crime. After that, the girls are all over him. He gets a girlfriend when he reveals his identity to his crush in the first movie, and in the second movie he hooks up with another hero, plus he gets a kiss at the end of the movie from Chloe Grace Moretz as Hit Girl. They might be attracted to his desire to do good and willingness to sacrifice his well-being for others, but we're confident it's just the kick-ass suit. The Hunger Games. The Hunger Games is a movie about a love triangle. Oh, and a sadistic deadly game designed to make children fight to the death. But that's more of a B story. The real action is in the tense fight for affection between Katniss.
Oh, you scare me to death. Damn you.
Named, of course, after a beautiful flower. Gale, which is a mighty gust of wind. And Peeta, named after bread. Katniss, we all know, is the incomparable Jennifer Lawrence. Thor's equally sexy younger brother Liam Hemsworth plays Gale. And the role of Peeta belongs to Josh Hutcherson, whom you may know from such films as The Hunger Games. Katniss is torn between the two men, but ultimately, the handsome hunter and soldier Gale actually loses to the geeky, artistic baker Peeta. Katniss and Gale just grew apart over the years, while Peeta was there to grow and evolve with Katniss, making them the better match. Stranger Things. Between the tabletop RPG games and the science fiction monsters, Stranger Things is chock full of awesome nerdiness. Jonathan Byers is one of such nerds, who is as into photography as he is into Nancy Wheeler. Unfortunately, Nancy is dating Steve, who is a massive jerk. Luckily, Nancy gains some sense and separates herself from Steve, all the while spending time with Jonathan instead. The two form a real connection on their hunt to find their lost loved ones, and their friendship is one that could potentially blossom into a romantic relationship. Nancy is back with Steve at the end of season 1, but Jonathan did a great job laying down the groundwork for a deeper relationship in season 2. By being her friend first before anything else. It's only a matter of time before the geek gets the girl, but maybe he should sort of stop stalking her and being creepy first. A 2016 study published in New Ideas of Psychology revealed what exactly makes a person creepy. In a nutshell, any sort of unwarranted sexual innuendos or advances are a big no-no. That includes secretly taking pictures of her hanging out with her friends, Jonathan. The Big Bang Theory. If these guys can find girls, there's no reason anyone else can't find girls. Howard found a girl who enjoys his terrible jokes, Sheldon found an exact copy of himself in female form, but it was Leonard who had to put in the real work for his girl.
Are you suggesting that if we let Penny stay, we might succumb to cannibalism?
Leonard develops a crush on Penny the minute he sees her, but it takes him quite a while to work up the courage to ask her out. In the meantime, though, he's able to develop a long-lasting friendship with her, so when the timing was right, he asked her out, and she said yes. Penny was just looking for a good guy, someone she could trust and be comfortable with. She knew Leonard was that guy because of all the time she stood by her throughout their friendship together. The Simpsons. Milhouse has always had a thing for Lisa, but she never seemed to want to return the affection. That is, until the episode Homer Scissorhands. Milhouse goes overboard with his love proclamation, and Lisa lets him down in front of everyone. But once he moves on to a different girl named Taffy, Lisa can't help but feel jealous.
Taffy's up to something.
She spends the rest of the episode spying on the couple, trying to figure out what Milhouse's girlfriend is up to. In the end, she is caught spying on them, and Taffy storms off saying that they're never going to work because he will always be in love with Lisa.
Milhouse, you're a great guy, but we're not gonna work out.
Milhouse is devastated and believes Lisa just wants him to be miserable, but then all of his dreams come true when she rushes over and kisses him. She just couldn't see what she had until it was gone, and it made her realize her true feelings for Milhouse.
Everything's coming up, Milhouse!
It took a lot of time and effort on Milhouse's part, but in the end, it paid off for him. Geek culture has never been more popular, and with our newfound ability to talk to women, it's only a matter of time before we take over the world. What's your technique for getting a girlfriend? Help out your fellow geeks and tell us all about it in the comments below. Don't forget to click that like button and subscribe to CBR to catch even more videos on comic books, movies, TV shows, pop culture, and more.